Hey guys, in this tutorial you're going to learn another technique for solving or simplifying algebraic expressions called expanding. It's a pretty useful technique to manipulate equations that involve brackets. So let's just have a look at a normal expression that doesn't have any algebra. So let's have a look at 5 times bracket 2 plus 3. Now, if you remember our first tutorial, we said that whatever is inside brackets needs to be completed first. So 2 plus 3 is 5, so therefore we have 5 times 5, which is 25. Now, the funny thing is, this expression can be rewritten the same way if we try our expanding technique, which is when we have a number in front multiplied by a number of terms in the brackets, we can simply get the number in front and multiply each term separately on the inside and get the same result. So let's try doing that. 5 times 2 plus 5 times 3, and that becomes 10 plus 15, which is 25 again. So how is this possible? Well, it makes sense because if you think of it, 5 times 5, if you think about it, 5 times 5 is the same thing as 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. Now, 5 times 2 is the same thing as 5 plus 5, and 5 times 3 is the same thing as 5 plus 5 plus 5. So when we have a plus in the middle, if you plus them together, it's exactly the same thing as 5 times 5. So that's why this technique works. So expanding is simply the process of getting the number in front of the bracket and multiply each term inside the bracket, and that way you don't have to write the brackets anymore. Now let's apply this technique to an algebraic equation. So let's try it to 5 times 2 plus x. Now there is actually no way for you to solve it normally as you did with the numbers, right? Because there's no way for you to figure out what 2 plus x equals. So therefore the only thing you can do is expanding, which means getting the term in front multiplied by each term on the inside. So 5 times 2 is 10, 5 times x is 5x. So you have just expanded this equation. Now let's try expanding a couple of other equations. Expand the following. Okay, so let's try expanding these equations. We have 5 multiplied by x is 5x. 5 times 3 is 15. You have 6 times x, which is 6x. 6 times negative 2 is negative 12. So you have to be careful when you have a minus sign in the middle. If you have a minus sign in the middle, the sign stays with the number after the sign. So instead of going 6 times 2, you actually do 6 times negative 2, which makes it negative 12. Now let's try this third one. We have 2x times x is 2x squared. 2x times y is 2xy. And the last one, x squared times x is x cubed. X squared times negative 3 is minus 3x squared. So obviously you need to be pretty familiar with multiplying terms in algebra in order to do these questions. If you've forgotten how to multiply in algebra, have a look at lesson 2 again on simplifying algebraic equations. Okay, thanks for watching this tutorial. See you next time.